Hey guys, it's Dear Diablo from shopyverse.com, and I'm here working on a t-shirt on my stream. So I'm just setting it up real fast. Hey guys, hey, what's up? Tisha Banks Williams. Hey, how's it going? Thanks for checking out my stream. I appreciate it. And if you're just watching, I'm setting up a t-shirt, working on some custom shirts. This one's for Scott, always on my mind, forever in my heart. So what I want to do is just put always in my mind. I always want to put the wording on first. So I'll use these dagger strokes. Make the letters always on my mind. It's really great artist, Jaime Rodriguez. He does lettering, and it's really good. He does the single dagger strokes, but what I like to do is I kind of like to just sketch it out, draw it out first, and then I'll go over the letters. I'll take my time, just going a little slower. Thickening the first part of the letter. M for mind, like the M right here. When time forgets you, it's so hard to that way it's more bold and it stands out. So always on my mind, and then I want to throw some you know, wings and stuff like that. Hey, what's going on, Tobias? Hey, how's it going, man? Richard, Sergeant, Jimmy, James, all you guys, thanks for checking out my stream. I appreciate it. So always in my mind, and then I want to put forever in my heart. Underneath. So always start the corner. Always like to make the first letter, kind of give it some, like, style, so I flare it, add some like swirls. Forever. My heart. And then I can go back over the first letter again, like the F. Just to give it a bolder look. Forever in my heart. Sometimes I'll add little like curly lines to the bottom just to have it more stylized. And then add some, kind of like dragging some lines to the swirls off the top part of the letter and sometimes at the bottom. A little beat of the letter. So then I want to add the wings on here. And Let me fix this real fast. It keeps that messing up a lot. Does anyone add the wings? I think you can add like the little feathers underneath. Hey, what's going on, guys? Thanks for checking out the stream. I appreciate it. And if you're just joining, I'm working on a custom t-shirt. Always on my mind, forever in my heart. You kind of like drop little wings, feathers. Downstroke, upstroke, downstroke, upstroke. Downstroke, upstroke, it's pretty much how I do it. And it's like a little like W or a little U I make for the inside of the wings. They want to draw hearts underneath. All right, forever my heart. Then I kind of want to outline and put like a little ribbon, kind of what I'm making. I'm gonna do that around the word. Kind of highlights the word. So just focus in on it. Or anybody like, you know, see the shirt. Focus in on the same. Always. My mind. Up a little bit. Make some little claws in here. I
and make a little cloud on the other side. I'm on the wing.
There you go.
You don't have to make sure the shirt's exactly the same, you know? They're all a little different. I think a lot of people think that if you don't make it exactly the same, it's not as good. I've been doing this for, I don't know how many years. Started when I was 15, 16 years old in the flea market, and all my customers love my work. And they always just tell me that, hey, it doesn't have to be exactly like a like this shirt. We love it anyways. But don't worry about it. Just do whatever you like to make, you know, your style, because that's how ours work. And you can always get the best work if, you know, you tell it the creative person, whoever designing something, do that. But, you know, it's all just a learning process. Every time you do a shirt, work on different designs, different lettering, different kind of examples. All right, so always in my mind, forever in my heart, Scott. And hey guys, appreciate you checking out my stream. And hey, what's going on? Jane, Jack, Swan, Amanda, Grace, Steve, John, Billy, Tillman. Hey, what's up, Tillman, man? I don't know, you watch my streams. I've talked to you forever since college. Jimmy, Richard, Sergeant, all you guys, thanks for checking out my stream. I really appreciate it. I want to fill the heart in. A little outline around it. Because I find that if I'm always looking at the last shirt I did as a reference, I can't ever really get into my work and really make it really good. I'd rather make a good shirt for somebody than make an average shirt by always trying to just mimic or copy the same little exact thing I did before. So don't stress out about it. Just make something nice. People appreciate if it looks nice. They're not going to be like, oh, I can't believe it's not exactly like that other one. It's not good. I've never had anybody in my entire life as an artist say that. Unless they specifically ask, they want it all the same. So I'm airbrushing the design. And what I'm doing now is kind of like framing the picture. So I'll make like a circle around it. And that draws the eye inside the center to highlight Scott or whoever you're having put making a shirt for, you know? And you know, I find there's a lot of beauty in chaos when it comes to art. Vincent van Gogh was one of the greatest artists, and his work was so chaotic, but you know, it had this like beauty to it. I really try to embrace that when I paint. And I think if you're like that, if you're like me with what you do, don't be so judgmental. You know, you're not always going to be like somebody else's work. So just do what you want to, and as an artist, and it'll be all right. So always my mind's done, forever in my heart's done. Scott, let's move on to the back. Hey guys, thanks for checking out my stream on YouTube, and also streaming on Twitch, and I'm streaming on Facebook right now. So if I'm not responding to you sometimes, I'm usually just painting or just looking at another screen for the channel. I appreciate it, though, for
everyone that's watching. So drop a share, drop a like. That really helps out my stream. I appreciate it a lot. And it helps me do my work and helps me get my art out there and, you know, food on the table and just try to survive as an artist. It's always hard to you know, do what you love to do and continue on. But I always say never give up on what you love. Now it's the back. The back we're putting, they wanted to put say goodbye, don't follow. Seems a little odd, but the customer is always right. So, we start with the lettering again. I'm looking for that. No one's on YouTube. So say goodbye. Capital S. And some lowercase letters. Okay, and then goodbye is G. So I always make the first letter larger and the other one smaller. It just, it's in shirt design, I think it's easier to just read and break apart that way. Say goodbye, and then don't follow. It just looks like cooler. I mean, whenever you paint a letter, don't think of it as writing. It's not writing, it's drawing. You are writing a word, but whenever I paint something, like a letter, I don't think of it like that. That way you can have some dynamic, you know, like swirls or strokes. Okay. I mean, when you write a letter, you're not going to write it like that. When you draw it, you can draw it cool, you know? So F-O-L-L-O-W. Let's get a square. And sometimes the letters taper off or there's, you know, it doesn't exactly meet, and that's fine. I mean, you could sit here all day and try to connect the dots all the time, but then you miss the whole idea of making a piece of art. Making a piece of art is the whole thing, how it looks, and at the end, if it's a little chaotic, if one piece is chaotic, it's fine, but as the whole, if it's, you know, looks good, if the whole is beautiful, and that's all that matters. That's my outtake on art and my style and how I paint. And if you like it, like I said, please drop a share, drop a like, all the good stuff that helps me out so much. I really thank you guys for following my stream. Hey, what's going on, Desiree? RIP. Yeah, this is our rest in peace shirt. Thanks. I haven't seen you for a while. Let's see. Hope you're doing good. Donnie, Monica, Juan, Jax. Hey guys, thanks for checking out my stream. I really appreciate it. And what I'm going to do now is add some prayer hands. What I do is get the templates right here, spray some spray adhesive. And what I do is I use 3M General All Purpose number 45 spray adhesive. It's really good. Shoot up the can and it really sticks on there really well. My friend Chino from Vegas and Jonathan told me about what, actually Jonathan told me this to get the 45 one on Amazon. So if you want to get some of this stuff, it's on Amazon.com and just go to, you know, just Google 3M 45 spray and you can find it and it works great. And this thing keeps on falling, but you prop it up a little differently. But I appreciate you guys checking out my stream. And this is the last part. Let's just put it on the desk. This easel's kind of broke. And I want to make sure I finish this. All right, so let me adjust this real fast. appreciate you guys being patient with me. Alright. Say goodbye. And do not follow. Just don't follow. Flip it on. You can have another clip around here somewhere. Here it goes. So I don't get as much overspray on that side of the shirt. So now let's add some purple to it. The two colors I wanted was black and purple. Hey guys, what's going on? Donnie, Monica, Steven, appreciate it. Check out my stream. And if you just joined me, I'm working on a memorial shirt for Scott. And how in the words say goodbye? Good. Bye. I work kind of fast. What it does is it really gets me in the rhythm. So I was swaying back and forth when I'm painting. I kind of just kept feeling like, I don't know, it's like a dance in a way. Although it's a really like bad dance for me, but I'm not really into dancing. Actually, I'm not a dancer at all. But I guess the rhythm of painting. So I'll outline the letters, the stroke. And you know what, I'm going kind of fast, let me slow down. So what I try to do, and I don't do this perfect all the time, is highlight, drag, spray the purple paint from left of the black, leaving a little drop shadow. And when you leave a drop shadow, that kind of just makes it look a little more bold. All right, so the next part would be filling in the prayer hands. So the stencil's on there with a 3M multi-purpose spray. If it doesn't make contact perfectly, just push it down with your finger. I'm always running my fingers across the prayer hands, the stencils, and that pushes it down. And what that creates is more contact to the template. So the greater the contact to the template, from the shirts to the template of the stencil, that makes it sharper. It makes a sharper stencil outline. Alright, I'll switch to the other color again, purple. Now hold my finger off to the stencil. And then go over the black again. Black is a dark color, it's an opaque color. And purple right here, what I'm using is detailed red violet. Or actually, this might be detailed violet. It's either red violet or about one of the two, but it is just like a purple color. And that's the point I'm trying to make. So when you add purple on top of black, what it becomes, if you look at it, it's just a darker purple. The black's still there, but it kind of shades the black and gives it a little brighter color to the black. So it darkens the purple and brightens up the black. I'm going to use these dagger strokes, push the airbrush here down, coming back, down, coming back, down, coming back. Air down, pull back the trigger, air down, so that contributes. I kind of flare it and tapers off. So you should probably go slower than me. So you can make it taper off, like, slowly, and, you know, slowly tapers off and then kind of disappears into the distance. I think it looks really pretty that way. And everything is emanating from the center. I'm a super nerd, so when I talk, I kind of jumble my words because I'm trying to, like, find an easier way to say it. So if I say use words and if I use words, they seem like I don't know, words that aren't used for art terminology. I'm not being some, like, stuck up snob person. It's just how I talk. I remember when I was little, kids would make fun of me saying they think you're better than me because of the way I speak with words, you know? And that's not bad, just how I talk. So hopefully you guys can still have patience with me. I appreciate it. So, okay, so then I want to take off the template and fill in the prayer hands. Adding purple to the sleeves. Joey, always great work. Thanks. Thanks, Joey. There's the dagger strokes again. Down. Press down, pull like the trigger. And push forward again. Down, back, forward. Down, back, forward. Down, back, forward. Down, back, forward. So that's part's done. And now I want to do is add some. Or doves. Or these are actually not doves. I think they are actually. To the shirts. The other ones I had the doves on the top, but there isn't space there, so I'm gonna put them on the side right here. I think it still looks good even though it's not the same as the other one. Yo, it's peaceful. All right, then those little dagger strokes to fill in the wings. I just think they kind of dry off a little bit. And paint dries really fast. Hey, what's going on? Hey, what's up, guys? Tisha, still not here to do our shirts, but we work. You know, I still have a website, so if you want to check it out, it's shopyourverse.com, and it can ship out shirts around the country. And if you need anything done, just DM me. I could, you know, set up some stuff. So the stencil is still kind of sticky from spraying it. And that way you don't have to put so much spray adhesive on it. I can still hold it on there and make the templates. And if you're working on a lot of shirts, and I usually do festivals and events, so I'm always constantly churning out shirts, and I have to be done fast, like within, you know, 10 minutes or so, to have a lot of customers. It's good to kind of teach yourself to move a little faster or slower depending on what you're working on. So now I'm gonna add some clouds around here. I think that would look cool. Like little kind of like humps on M, or I feel like it was M. And then shade it in. Big M, small M. Like little semi-half circles. Now I start with the larger circle on the outside and then gradually make it smaller as I move towards the center of the design that I'm putting it around. So put some around here, just filling in the shirt. It's not as random. I try to balance it out. So I have one here, a cloud group in the top corners, in the top sides, and I want to put a cloud group down here. Hey, homie, looking good. Hey, thanks, Jesse. What's up, Scott, Christina, John, all you guys. Thanks for checking out my stream. And if you like the stream, please drop a share or a like. That really helps out my channel a lot. So it's a little off right there. It's not perfect. Nothing is. That mesh cloud is right there. Maybe move to the top. All right, that's cool. Add a kind of flare right here. Add some more purple. Hey guys, thanks for joining the stream. If you're just checking it out, I'm working on a memorial t-shirt for Scott. And this is for awareness for, you know, drug abuse. So there's some ribbons on the side in purple. You want it on the t-shirt. I'll do that part off camera though. It's kind of hard to mess with what I'm streaming. But so then I look at the rest of the shirt right now, right? And I'm gonna add a little more kind of effect for around the four parts. I
kind of make like a bubble around the words, don't follow. That's really important. All right. There you go. There's the shirt. We can slow down. Kind of look at all the spots that I have. I don't make every shirt like this for live streaming. I really wanted to just show you what you can do on shirt. All the different kind of designs and effects. It's like practice, you know? A little template, add some little design in here. Actually, I had this in the last shirt, so I kind of want to match it a little bit. So there we go. There's a lot on here. There's a lot going on, but ever since I started airbrushing at the flea markets when I was a kid, Gary, Indiana, that's where I started out. They really helped me become better, really good t-shirt artist, because they always kind of pushed me to do better. And I wouldn't even say criticize, I just said help, you know? So that's the style that I do, and I appreciate you watching. If you got something out of the stream, hopefully it helped out. I know I move super fast and I talk super fast. This is how I am. But hopefully, if you need any shirts for the holidays, hit me up, DM me. I'm on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. Just drop me a message or email me at mindlesspaint@gmail.com. That's my email address. So thank you guys for watching, and see you guys again. All right, I'm out of here. Later.